Welcome back to After the Fact. The National Telecommunications Commission has been under fire for granting frequencies once held by ABS-CBN to firms controlled by allies of President Rodrigo Duterte, with a group even calling it an almost midnight deal. But the NTC justified its move, saying the reassignment of the frequencies was done for public good. The agency also assured the public they did their due diligence in granting those frequencies. We're now joined by Attorney Rodolfo Salalima, the former Secretary of the Philippines' ICT Department. Good evening, sir, and thank you for joining us on the program.
Magandang gabi, Christian. Magandang gabi, bayan. Thank you for having me in your program.
Let's go to the very first, to a very basic question. Is there still a way for ABS-CBN to recover these frequencies which have been assigned already by the National Telecommunications Commission
for as long
other
as
companies?
ABS-CBN acquires back its franchise, for as long as it acquires back its certificate of public convenience, and for as long as the frequencies assigned to the new assignee are not used, then there is a chance for ABS-CBN to take back those franchises. If at the time the request for the return of these frequencies, they are still not used.
Okay,
or otherwise, the decision of the NTC in the 2006 granting the frequencies to advanced media broadcasting system is recalled or reconsidered by the NTC.
Okay. In the meantime, the frequencies that were granted to Manny Villar's Advanced Media Broadcasting System, the other frequency granted to Sunshine, at saka isa po sa Aliw Broadcasting Corporation, gaano katagal nila pwedeng gamitin po yun, assuming that they would use them?
Well, the grant of the correct frequency has its own duration. But the problem here is, once granted, even if the duration is temporary, it may last forever. Like, say, for example, in the subject case, the NTC erroneously granted to Advanced Media Broadcasting System the frequencies of Channel 2 to applicant Advanced Media Broadcasting, or also granted to the same applicant the frequencies of Channel 16 of ABS-CBN, which are the digital broadcast frequency. And I feel that order of the NTC of January 5, 2022, granting those frequencies, are erroneous, contrary to law, in fact, in violation of Republic Act 7925 in regard the administration and grant of frequencies, and in violation of the practice and policies of the NTC. That being said,
okay,
I feel that the grant of the frequency should be reconsidered, and that a motion for reconsideration must be filed so as to void that grant of the frequency.
Who is supposed to file that MR?
Pardon?
Who is supposed to file that motion for reconsideration?
There is an oppositor in that case of Advanced Media Broadcasting System, and they are an aggrieved party. And for that matter, any party who feels that it has a right to the frequency and that it is an aggrieved party to the decision, then they can file for a reconsideration of the case. Remember that in an attempt by the NTC to defend their void order, void because it is erroneous, they tried to advance reasons which, instead of answering questions, raise more questions than answers. And I am concerned by that because the NTC is in law an independent quasi-judicial body, but they admitted in fact that in rendering the decision, they consulted and found the approval of three agencies, which should not be done because under Republic Act 7925, the NTC as a quasi-judicial body is an independent body.
Okay, so that's one problem that you saw. How about the others, which made you conclude that this grant of frequencies to advanced media was erroneous and contrary to law? Ano po po yung ibang basis niyo?
Unang-una, sabi nila, there were other interested applicants to the said frequency, but they did not consider these applicants. In other words, the grant of the frequency was solely on the basis of the sole application of Advanced Media Broadcasting System. Now, Republic Act 7925, particularly Article 2, Section 4C of that law, says that the spectrum or frequencies shall be administered by government or the NTC in the interests of the public and in accordance with international agreements and conventions to which the Philippines is a party. Anong nangyari dito? That same provision says the frequency must be granted to the best qualified applicant, meaning that there are several applicants which must be considered. As admitted by the spokesperson of the NTC, they did not consider the applicant but only considered this application. And therefore, under that law, the grantee cannot be said to be the best qualified applicant because there was only one applicant who was considered in the rest were itsapuera. Secondly,
but in the first place po, how do you determine who is the best qualified?
Well, paano
pag sinabi ng NTC, baka may problema sa papers before.
Yeah, there are criterion or criteria used before, in fact, in our cases before, which are the basis for grading an applicant and on the basis of which the NTC can come up with the best qualified applicants from the several applicants who were interested in the frequencies. Pero sabi ng spokesperson, Republic Act 7925 daw does not apply, allegedly because Republic Act 7925 refers only to the Telecommunications Commission. But under the Article 2 which I cited, the dispensation or grant of the frequency must be in accord with international conventions and agreement to which the Philippines is a party. If they only have read the International Telecommunications Union Constitution and Convention and the very definition of the term telecommunications in broadcast, broadcasting is a process of communications which is a species of telecommunications. And to that extent, therefore, the broadcasting is telecommunications, and therefore 7925, which was violated by the NTC, binds frequencies which are granted to a broadcast applicant.
Okay, and, so that's one. Mm. Can you cite? Go ahead, sir.
What I am more concerned here is the fact that under that same law, even the secretary of the DOTC, now the secretary of the DATC, cannot in any way influence, review, or reverse the decision of the NTC because as a quasi-judicial body, it is an independent body. And therefore, there is statement in their decision or order that they consulted other agencies is a statement which is contrary to their, as a judicial body, independent from any other agencies of government. Remember
about the other
remember the case about the of Antibay versus CIR on the rights to due process, on the obligations of a quasi-judicial body. In that case, the Supreme Court said that an independent tribunal, be it judicial or quasi-judicial, must, in making a decision personally and out of its own independent consideration of the facts in the law in the case. There, in that decision, they admitted that they consulted and that their decision here has the approval of three agencies of government.
So hindi na nila dapat ginawa yun. How about the other frequencies granted to Sunshine and Aliu Broadcasting? Did you
I
also
am not quite particular about the facts of this, of the frequencies granted to Sunshine and to the other religious group. But I assume that in the grant of the frequencies to both of them, they should also consider the provisions on the administration of frequencies under Republic Act 7925.
Okay. And yung pong ano, yung provisional authority, what exactly does that mean? Because that was the one granted to advance some media broadcasting system, for example.
Provisional authority is in effect a temporary authority prior to you being granted a certificate of public convenience and necessity in case of telecommunications operators or the more permanent CPC in relation to broadcast companies.
Okay. What kind of capability does, let's say, advanced media broadcast system need to show to be able to say that indeed it was the best qualified?
Well, there are guidelines in the order itself which they must accomplish in that, among others, in 6 months, they have to start establishing the operations, in that in a year's time, they must start operations and their guidelines. But more than that, it is important that the grant of the frequency to them must be in accord with 7925, in that even if they are the most qualified, they must see to it that what they have granted to the applicant must be only enough as are necessary to address the viewership or subscriber of the applicants as well as the area covered by their operations.
Okay.
In this case, Christian, understand that the frequencies given to advanced media are the frequencies being used by ABS-CBN at its peak when its viewership and when its area of coverage was incomparable versus the viewership and area of coverage of the startup that is advanced media broadcast system. Therefore, the grant of the frequency is much too much, and therefore, to the extent that there was an excess, the grant of that excess frequency is void.
Okay, finally, we don't have much time anymore, Attorney Salalima. Do you consider this grant of frequency a form of political payback for President Duterte? And do you consider this as a midnight deal, considering that it happened a few days before the start of the election period?
Those are motherhood statements. What I am saying here is this grant of frequency is contrary to law. And therefore, it being contrary to law, contrary to the guidelines provided by 7925, therefore, that order in regard to the grant of the frequencies is void, and therefore, it ought to be the subject of a motion for reconsideration.
Okay. Former DICT Secretary Rodolfo Salalima, thank you very much, sir, for